What's up, everybody? It's Luke James, not the singer. If you're looking to get your music reviewed, you can hit up this email that's right here. But today, I'm going to hit you up with my thoughts and opinions on this Pete Sayke album called Heaven Can Wait. Now, Pete Sayke is a rapper coming out of Chicago who's dropped some solo work as well as some work with his group called Grumpy Old Men. Not to be confused with Jack Lemmon and Walter Matthau, but shout out to them. They're some classic acting legends. And if you want to find out more about Pete Sayke and his music, this project and other things, just take a look at the information box I got for you underneath this video. But one of the things I really like about this project right here is that there is a lot of thought-provoking content and social commentary. Pete is certainly the type of artist that likes to use his platform to speak on issues, and that's something that I appreciate. For example, on the song Blue Blood Gangland, he speaks on the dangers of driving while black and the fact that police are just rarely held accountable for their actions, so I do appreciate that he's bringing these things to the forefront. I did find this beat to be a little bit cluttered though. There's just a lot going on with the sample chopping and the drums, but it's not really a bad beat. It just seems like there's a lot going on, and he does hold this one together with his content and also with those nice flows. Now the great content continues on the songs Great Again, featuring Roy Kinsey, and also The Optics, where on these tracks he's just speaking on the current political climate in the United States of America. You got the poor getting poorer, the rich getting richer, education is suffering, things are just fucked up all over the place, so these two tracks keep that content going, and it's great to know that we have artists like this who want to speak on these issues and try to provide some sort of change. So these are both very dope tracks, and I also got to shout out that beat on The Optics. This was one of my favorite beats because it has a little bit of a neo-soul vibe to it, just very smooth with some nice bubbling bass, and also Hole in My Pocket is another favorite beat. This one has some nice jazz production, very smooth and mellow once again, and it has these gorgeous vocals from Selena Carrera. I really was feeling what she was doing on here. She stood out a lot to me, so that was one of my favorite features. And this track just deals with people's social media obsession, just how everyone is trying to keep up with the Joneses. We post our best selves on social media. We want to be like some of these other peoples who are ahead of us. You know what I'm getting at, man. Just getting a little bit ranty here. But this track was dope because I think that's another issue that's important to speak on. A lot of people are trying to be something that they ain't, when really you should just be happy with yourself and just take your time, man. You're going to get where you're going. Just enjoy life and what it is. And since I did bring up some of the features on here, I gotta shout out the boom bap banging posse cut called Shaolin Fangs. This one features Pete, Ill Brown, Stick Figure, and Tona going in. I thought Stick and Vest actually had the best flows on this, so they were my favorite part, but everyone did their thing on this, and as I said, man, it's just a boom bap posse cut banger, so if you like those type of tracks where you're just getting a bar fest over some hard-hitting sample-based production, you're absolutely gonna love this track, and it was easily one of my favorites, man. I think Pete has a more traditional hip-hop sound here, but there are a couple of tracks that do bring trap elements, just a couple of them, so we will talk about them. On the song called On Everything, you're noticing those trap elements with the drums. You're also getting a very dope-ass feature from Ad 2 on here. Both Pete and Ad 2 are dropping some fiery flows. You're getting a little bit of black empowerment on this track too, so that was dope. And then on the track What It Is, we get a nostalgic trunk slapper. This one actually features Pete once again, obviously it's his album, and also Dre Day and Blueprint. On this one, they're just coming through with some nostalgic throwback bars, rapping about what it was like to work at Mickey D's, take your parents' car on tour, and just that generational gap with the music. Just a really dope track that I think a lot of us can relate to. And I like that both of these tracks are bangers with bars, man. They are both the perfect example of the fact that you don't have to sacrifice lyricism when you're making trunk slappers. You can still come through with some great bars. So that's why I often shit on some of these artists who make bangers but can't rap for shit. Because people will say, oh man, it ain't about the bars. They're just trying to make bangers. But that doesn't mean you got to sacrifice lyrics 100%. So these were dope tracks, man. These are another couple of favorite tracks on here. And since I did mention the nostalgic vibes, I definitely have to talk about the title track on here. This one has Pete just going into detail about his life, just how hip-hop came into it, how he built up throughout his life. So I thought it was very interesting because it does make you connect with him. It gets very personal. A lot of this project, as I said, is getting social commentary going throughout it, a lot of political issues as well, but on this track you really get to know Pete. He speaks on coming up through rap, how he used to actually work with Rhymefest, which I thought was pretty cool, and you're just getting some very vivid storytelling here. At one point in this, he actually wonders if chasing his hip-hop dreams is just fucking his life up, so that's something that I'm sure a lot of rappers and artists out there will relate to, so I appreciate this track. But at the end of the day, man, this is a very dope indie slash underground project, so I'm gonna give it a 4 out of 5. I really don't have a lot of problems with this one. My least favorite track would be Me, You, Gary, and Sid. I just didn't connect to the lyrics too much here, and I thought the beat was kind of simplistic. It was just some very simple vocal pad based stuff. But in spite of that, man, this is a dope-ass project. Only about 40 minutes, so there's not all kinds of filler. Doesn't overstay its welcome. You are getting a little bit of variety, because as I mentioned, you do get a couple of bangers. But for Pete to take his music even higher, like, not to say this is bad, I mean, a 4 out of 5 is very good. I give those out quite sparingly. But to go even higher, I would just like to hear some more innovation and experimentation. I think he's a dope-ass rapper. Like, you're getting plenty of good flows, strong vocal performances on here as well. But I'd like to see him mix it up a bit, maybe with his rapping, and even with the production styles, maybe do some more concepts centered around the social commentary and some of these ideas. Just mix it up a bit, man. But still, 4 out of 5 is dope, but I think he can do even better just by experimenting and maybe innovating a bit more so he stands out from the crowd even more. But that's just what I got to say about this project. You check it out for yourself and then hit me up in the comment section with your thoughts. And of course, man, check out all my sites and social media so you can show me love and show me lots of it. Thank you for watching, everybody. I will see you next time.